This program is sponsored by Dave Stahl.
Welcome back to Hour 2 of Gun Sports Radio, where your hosts, Dave Stahl, Lance Pelkey, and Michael Schwartz, educate you on anything and everything related to our Second Amendment right. Visit gunsportsradio.com with your questions and comments or to learn how to become a sponsor and or guest of the show. Now here comes Hour 2 of Gun Sports Radio and your hosts, Dave, Lance, and Michael.
All right, folks, welcome back to Gun Sports Radio, FM 96.1, AM 1170, The Answer. By the way, Lance is a little under the weather today, and he's just taking it nice and easy, and I'm sure he's home listening. This hour is brought to you by our good friends at Cali Key. Drop in a Cali Key into any AR-15 or AR-10 to instantly make it California compliant. For more information, check out Cali Key at CaliKey.com. That's CaliKey.com. Self-defense and emergencies can happen to anyone. And unfortunately, the justice system may not be on your side. While you protect your family and property, U.S. LawShield is here to defend you 24/7, 365 days a year with the comprehensive self-defense coverage at an affordable price. Bad guys don't take days off, and neither does our coverage. What's your plan after you defend yourself or your family? Consider a plan from U.S. LawShield. Check them out today at uslawshield.com. That's uslawshield.com. All right, this segment is brought to you by the San Diego County Gun Owners. For as little as $10 a month, you can join San Diego County Gun Owners at sdcgo.org. That's sdcgo.org. Join today and help solve the problem, because it takes a group of us to make it happen. Joe Drammissi, the blogger, is here. So what's your story this week, my friend?
So I thought, well, since it's the end of the year, we would kind of wrap up some things and take a look at some of the good and bad things that happened in terms of California gun laws and the stuff we have to deal with. And, you know, those of us gun owners that keep up on this kind of stuff, we're probably aware, everybody's probably aware of a lot of the stuff that happened in the past year. A lot of laws that just, you know, pretty much infringe on our rights, you know, as gun owners. And what we have is, if you look at some of them, like the ammo law, for instance, is a big one to think about, because that, I think the new ammo laws that went into effect in July probably impact most of us, you know, more than any of the other stuff that's happened. And I was just reading recently too, I don't know if you've seen this, Michael, where they were saying like over 62,000 people have been rejected or turned down for ammo purchases.
Yep.
And these aren't 62,000 criminals or people that should have been legitimately turned down. These are 62,000 mostly okay people that should have been able to purchase ammo.
Yeah. So what's their reasons?
I think they're working out still a lot of bugs in the system. There's things where if there's a conflict between different addresses, if you'd moved recently and on one document there's one address, on another document there's another address.
Oh, well, okay.
Things like that. And and I think a lot of it is just things that aren't quite that legitimate. It's just there's bugs. The system is overwhelmed and working with that. At least that's what I hear from gun shops and things like that. Have you heard that kind of stuff, Michael?
You know, you don't dot an I, you don't cross a T if you're not. So they're not really doing a background check exactly. In other words, it's not really going to the same system as when you do your DROS and buy a gun. They're checking a whole other separate database to see if all your information matches up with their information. And that information comes from the database when you buy a firearm. So you buy a firearm, you put all your information in, and then they take that database and put it on another database. So you could be, if you're not a criminal, you know, you've never committed a crime, you've never even had a speeding ticket, but if you haven't bought a gun in the state of California, they don't have a record of you. So you won't be able to buy ammo. And the only way to do that is to, you know, well, the best way to do it is to just go buy a gun and then use all the same information.
Yeah. And again, and all this stuff, you know, you have the same, you know, justification for these laws, I guess, is to increase public safety and to reduce crime And these laws do none of that stuff. And there were a whole host of them, and we've written about them over the last couple of months. That happened. But on the plus side, too, looking forward to 2020, there's room for optimism. A lot of these goofy laws are being challenged. And for instance, the famous Todd Gloria thing, the ban on the gun show in Del Mar.
Right.
Which, again, has absolutely no valid purpose at all other than to, you know, try to disrupt the gun shows here in San Diego. That's being challenged. There's a lawsuit that's challenging that one. The assault rifle ban. Now, our own John Dillon, along with the Firearms Policy Coalition and others, are challenging that law. So that's something that may get resolved in 2020, or at least will be addressed in 2020. There's a lawsuit challenging the ammo laws out here in California, so they'll be addressing that. The other one that banned purchases of firearms for people under 21, the 18 to 21 year old people.
Yep, just heard from John about that.
Yeah,
hopefully that'll go our way.
So there's a number of things to look forward to here in California anyway for 2020. So it's not all dismal and depressing. The other thing, if we look at it nationally, I know we've been talking here on the show the last couple of weeks about what's going on in Virginia. And the fact that, well, over 90 of the 95 counties and a number of their 38 cities back there have stepped up to fight the new gun control laws being proposed by the newly elected Democrats back there. And they've declared themselves sanctuary, Second Amendment sanctuary counties and cities. And, you know, we talked about this. There's really, it's not that there's any teeth to these things. It's not clear how, when these laws are enacted, say in January, whenever they come to, it's not to say how these counties are going to react, if they are going to resist or what they're going to do. But the fact that you've got that many counties, and, you know, and it's not just a, it's not so much a bunch of Second Amendment activists. When you get boards of supervisors, governing bodies for counties to step up and say things like that and to take that position, that's really strong, because, you know, your position, it's a positional authority thing. For instance, if I say something, my words don't carry as much weight, say, as Michael's words, Michael being the executive director of our group. So your position, you know, has a lot to do with the weight of your words. So when you get boards of supervisors and people at that level to step up like that, that's a big deal. And it'll be interesting to see how that goes next year when they start to resolve this stuff. And it'll be interesting if it attracts the attention of the Supreme Court.
It is a big deal. And it is, for lack of a better term, it's good. It is good that it's happening. It's it drives me crazy when I hear politicians say, hey, you know, that's just not, I'm not going to weigh in on that. You know, I'm just going to talk about filling potholes and everything. Yeah, you know, that's great. We want you to fill potholes. We want you to balance a budget. It's unfortunate that people have to get involved in a Second Amendment, you know, opinion. But geez, you know, we're electing you to be a leader. You know, we're electing you to be a community leader. And in all your literature, when you're running for office, you're standing there in front of a flag and looking regal and whatever.
And unless you're a Democratic presidential candidate,
yeah,
then there are no flags on the stage for some reason.
So be a leader, you know, step up and say, hey, you know what? My community doesn't agree with this. So I think it's important and it's good.
Yeah, and it is a good thing, because there's, you know, and no one knows how this is going to turn out, but something is going to get resolved in Virginia next year. And I think the rest of the country is watching. And the other big thing on the national level is the Supreme Court is hearing the challenge to New York City's gun transportation law. I guess it's being brought by the New York State Rifle and Pistol Association, I guess. And, you know, it may be that what's going on in Virginia will prompt the Supreme Court to make a ruling that's a little bit more broad and addresses the infringement of the Second Amendment. Because all these laws really, is what they do is they infringe on people's rights. So hopefully there's a lot to look forward to in 2020.
So how do people follow your blogs?
So again, go to our website, sdcgo.org or sandiegocountygunowners.com. Is that how we have it?
Yep.
There we go. I got it right this time.
And then
right.
Click on blog.
And then they can reach you as well if they have any comments or questions.
Click on the blog. Yes, we always look at the comments. We're a little bit slow responding to the comment, or at least checking to see if they're there. But within a couple of days anyway. It won't be immediate, but it's within a day or two.
How come he's looking at you?
I know. Right? And we can go to, you can find it on his blogs on our Facebook page, and you can also sign up for our email, and we send them out on the email. So there's a lot of ways to find the blogs. His blogs are also on Orange County Gun Owners website, Riverside County Gun Owners website, and soon to be on San Bernardino County gun owners website.
So I just bought my 1 year subscription to San Diego County Gun Owners, and I got deer in the headlights. He thought I handed him $100.
Just throwing me money.
Cute.
I was watching that while I was trying to talk here. I was watching that money going back and forth.
I know. Well, I'm on a radio show right now.
Well, I know, but if I just it just dawned on me, I had it in my pocket. If I don't give it to you, I'll forget.
There you go.
And that's what everybody should do. $10.
That's right.
It's $100 really for a year, right?
Right.
You can't beat it with a stick. All right, folks, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, a whole lot more. In fact, I think we got somebody calling in from U.S. LawShield.
Yeah, it's going to be a good one.
He's on the line. Can't wait to get to it. FM 96.1, AM 1170.
The Answer.
FM 96.1, AM 1170,
The Answer.
Hey, you know, California assault weapon laws make it almost impossible to own an AR pattern rifle. What's the solution? Cali Key. Easy conversion. Any mil-spec direct impingement AR platform rifle into a straight pull-out bolt-action rifle so it can have all the features without being considered an assault weapon. It is a true drop-in solution. No milling. No aesthetic modifications, no turning off your gas system. Keep your entire AR collection intact with a price you can afford. Go to CaliKey.com, CaliKey.com. Looking to do a little construction at your house? Everything from a kitchen remodel to a room addition to a full home? TDT Construction does it all. Don't overpay. Call TDT Construction today, 619-448-2363. 619-448-2363, or just go to tdtbuild.com. And remember, they're A-plus rated with the BBB. So are you looking for private individual CCW training? Well, have I got the guy for you, John Groff. John Groff has been providing individual CCW training classes for first-timers and people renewing their permits for years and years. John can arrange a time to fit your schedule, an affordable price with a calming professional demeanor. Call John Groff today, 619-933-4368, or swing by the Gun Range San Diego. He's normally there. All right, hey, Mike, who you got for your next guest?
From one of our best and favorite sponsors, U.S. Law Shield, who I believe we're all members of U.S. Law Shield. Kyle, who's the National Ops Manager from U.S. Law Shield, is joining us on the show. How are you doing, Kyle?
I'm doing good, brother. How are you?
Good, man.
We're living the dream. Did you have a good Christmas?
I did. How about you guys?
Living it. Loving it, loving it, loving it. Hopefully next year is going to be bright and prosperous for you as well.
Man, at the rate that things have been going, it is looking very good indeed.
So, what do you want to chat about today?
Oh, you know, you pick something. You know, I'm all yours. I've got a couple of stories that I can give you, with some member stories. You know, we've got so many members in so many different places. There's, different things will come up. We've got that. I've got a couple of things we've got going on I'd like to tell you about. Is we've got something we're doing called the $10,000 giveaway. It's a Train for Life giveaway. And what we're doing is for anybody who signs up for an event anywhere in the country where we operate, we're going to enter them into this Train for Life giveaway. And what all is involved in that is they register to attend one of our workshops or seminars in an area close to them. We're going to give them $5,000 worth of guns, $2,500 worth of ammo, and $2,500 worth of gear. Now, if there's ever been a deal out there better than that, I haven't seen it. That is an amazing thing that we're doing. It's the Train for Life giveaway. And again, that's if they sign up and register to attend an event. And where do they do that? Well, they can go to gunlawseminar.com, and it'll just walk them right through the process. They can pick what city, state, whatever, you know, wherever they're at, register for that event, and they are automatically entered. And we also was going to tell you guys about an event coming up on the 22nd for you guys in the San Diego area. So that's just kind of a couple of things off the cuff there that we got working.
So what do you got going on in San Diego? I just gave $100 to Mike to join San Diego County Gun Owners. Tell me about it. I may take my money back.
Well, I don't have that location on where I can look at it, but we are having an event in the area on the 22nd in San Diego. So it'll be a legal gun law seminar, legal topics, gun law education, training. Our kind of our company motto is armed and educated. So if you've ever attended one of our events, we cover a lot of what the law says. We have our attorneys that represent our members come to those and talk about the laws. And then sometimes we'll have a law enforcement officer. We'll come out and talk about interactions with law enforcement, educate the public on things to maybe do or not to do or say in the presence of an officer. And then, of course, our LawShield folks are there to help and assist in any way they can, talk about the program and that kind of stuff. So they can go to gunlawseminar.com, type in San Diego, and it'll tell them right where it's at.
So what kind of what does it cost to go to the seminar?
You know, it's $5 for our members and $10 for non-members. But you know what? If we've got somebody just wants to show up to the door, they can just walk up as well. But with the Train for Life giveaway, I'd really recommend that they, you know, go online and register so we can enter them for that giveaway.
So when is the giveaway?
We're going to let it run for a little while. I don't know the end date on that, but we're going to give everybody an opportunity across the country to hear about the event, learn about the event. We're advertising for the event and stuff. So they're going to have it's I don't know the exact date, but it's out there a way. So everybody will have plenty of time to, you know, catch an event somewhere to register. Not to worry. They got plenty of time.
So the event in San Diego, I just pulled it up to take a look at it, is actually at 511 Tactical, Mission Valley. Yep, 1257 Camino del Rio South, 511 Tactical, right in Mission Valley on the south side of the 8. And it is an active shooter getting out alive seminar, which I've not seen it yet, but I've heard outstanding
responses.
Yeah.
So can somebody go to that class and then go to another one and go to another one and go to another one and have now three or four shots at this prize?
Absolutely. So with the active shooter, I mean, just like today in the news, you know, we've had another shooting at the church in White Settlement, Texas. When you attend one of these events, they will cover some of the issues of run, hide, fight. But the other part of the education and training with that type of event is you have experienced professionals from the industry, law enforcement, that have been involved in those situations. And it's important that we provide those. We don't want somebody that's never been through it to try and talk to people about it. So it's just a wealth of information on things to do, not to do, especially if you're an armed citizen. You know, might not always be judicious to do this or do that. So they cover what the law says with regard to that. They talk about training and education, where to train, who to train with. And, of course, anybody that's listening, if you want to shoot and train, you can go to uslawshield.com. You can call us. We operate all over the U.S. with literally thousands and thousands of trainers and instructors, and especially in the San Diego area, we can send you to the very, very best folks right there. So the active shooters are always very, very popular. People always have a lot of questions with regards to those. Should they carry a gun to church? Can they carry a gun to church? Talk about what the law says with regards to what the state says about the laws there about carrying in church. Different states have different rules. So they vary a little bit from state to state. And, yes, they can go to that event. Then they can sign up and register for the next event. Maybe it's going to be a typical gun law seminar where we talk about just state-specific issues or laws. They can go to a different one somewhere else. We might be talking about upcoming legislation and how that's going to affect gun owners. So they vary. That's such a wide array of topics. So we do events multiple times a month all over the country. So, yes, and we would encourage them from a training and education standpoint to come to as many of those as possible.
Well, truly, I don't know if this is a controversial opinion, but it appears to me that most people who carry are overtrained on marksmanship and undertrained on everything else.
Sure. So go ahead. I'm sorry.
Which is why these seminars are so important. You know, they teach you where and when and how and what and all the extremely important stuff that you got to know when you when you're starting to carry. And here in San Diego, you know, most people have only had a CCW for, you know, fewer than 2 years because you couldn't get one before that. So there's a lot to know. There's a lot of education to be had.
There is. And with things like churches and places of employment where there's a lot of people, just because you have a gun doesn't always mean that you should use your gun. You know, my background comes from the investigations side of the world. I'm an investigator back in Oklahoma. And, you know, I've been in situations and seen a lot of things where something may happen. You know, you don't just want to whip out your gun and start shooting. Do you even know who the shooter is? Do you got a bunch of people between you and the shooter? They're going to jump up scared and run off. You might shoot an innocent person. Do you have sufficient cover, concealment and cover, two different things? So I'm also as a firearms instructor, that would be something that they need to know the difference. A couch will not protect you, but maybe a brick wall will. So I agree with you completely. It's if you've got a license, I would get out there, find a good trainer that you trust, that has the experience and knowledge to take you where you want to go, and then practice. Having a gun and carrying a gun is a great thing, but if you don't practice with your gun, you're not going to be good with your gun.
Well, your guy Frank from U.S. Law Shield out here is doing an outstanding job in Southern California and making sure that these seminars happen and coordinating with local shops and organizations and instructors and getting getting really great people involved with U.S. Law Shield. I think you guys are doing an outstanding job.
Outstanding, for sure.
A lot of that has to do with Frank. Do you know Frank? You got to know Frank, right?
I do know Frank.
Everybody knows Frank.
He's doing a good job. Man, he's a pretty popular guy these days.
I know. And by the way, I seen a movie the other day, and this guy was shooting at another guy, and he was behind a couch. He didn't get hurt. He must have had a different couch. He must have had a different couch than what you had.
Well, you know, most people... what they know about guns, they get from movies. So that's why we want people to come to these events, get out there to a LawShield event and learn, you know, fact from fiction. We don't want anybody hurt. We want everybody to be safe. We want them to know what the law says and protect themselves, protect their families.
Yeah. Is there any limitation on how many people you can take? Because for that kind of price, you're going to get bombarded.
No. You know what? If they got to sit on Frank's lap, we will have them come out. They can come out, bring as many people as we can.
Yeah, you have to pay extra for that. 511 is a big venue, so you guys can fit a lot of people in there.
Kyle, thank you very much.
Great place.
Yeah, thanks very much for taking time out of your day to call in. We really appreciate it, and we look forward to talking to you down the road. Thank you for all your support.
Hey, you guys are wonderful. Thank you for having us.
All right, folks, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, there's a whole lot more on FM 96.1, AM 1170,
The Answer.
Welcome back. You're listening to Gun Sports Radio, FM 96.1, AM 1170,
The Answer.
Hey, do you need to take a CCW class for your San Diego CCW? Well, do you want an Arizona, Florida, or other multi-state CCW? Visit CCWUSA.com. CCWUSA.com offers small class sizes and expert instruction to fit your schedule and your wallet. Three classes every month, two weekend classes, and one Friday class. That's Saturday, January 11th, Friday, January 17th, and Saturday, January 25th. Sign up quick because they do fill up. They all start at 8 a.m. in the morning. Private lessons are available as well. Great dates and times to meet your busy schedule. Check their website out for details on how to apply for your San Diego or multi-state CCW. At CCWUSA.com. At CCWUSA.com. Hey, folks, have you been to A.O. Swords Firearms in El Cajon? Holy mackerel. They got the widest selection of guns in San Diego County, with over 600 unique guns in stock, including hundreds of used guns. Go see their full-service experienced gunsmith. They can do everything from mild repairs to full custom firearms. A.O. Sword Firearms store located at 929 East Main Street in the city of El Cajon. Go to their website, aosword.com, or you can call them at 619-749-4867. Bill Buyer Repair, A.O. Sword Firearms, is your one-stop shopping for all things firearms. That's aosword.com. Again, 619-749-4867. And with that being said, we have our expert on the line, the man, David Chong. How you doing, bud?
Gentlemen, I am so happy to be closing out this year with you.
Yeah, we are too, and I hope you had a wonderful Christmas, and we know your New Year's is going to be rocking.
Fantastic. Yeah, good stuff. Was that Joe on the line earlier talking about the ammo background checks?
Yes, it was.
Yes, it was. He's sitting right here, in fact.
You got it absolutely right. 62,000, I guess, California's turned down for ammo.
Yeah, that was the number I'd used. Did you hear anything about the whys or the reasons there? Because I was...
I wanted to, since we're selling ammo over the counter, I wanted to maybe give a little personal insight into that, both anecdotal and also some statistics.
Sure.
Sacramento Bee reported that number translates to about 1 in 5 transactions declined. And that matches almost exactly our ratio in the shop. I tell you what, we're getting police officers declined. We're getting members of the military declined, people who own multiple firearms declined. One of the big reasons that we see is leave it to the state to not be able to get just a simple name right. The California driver's license system, the format that you enter the names at the DMV, doesn't match the DROS system formatting, especially in regard to suffixes. So if you're unfortunately of a third or a junior, you don't have the right place to put your suffix on the DROS background check for your ammo, and they'll kick you back declined. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we see a lot of them for that. Also, people who think they have a gun registered but they don't at their current address. Not only does their driver's license have to match their address. But also they have to have bought their most recent gun at that address. Otherwise, the guns that they had registered at their prior address don't update automatically. Even though you update it in the state's DMV system, that doesn't update the DOJ system.
So, David, if someone's denied, then what is it just they come back and try again a day or two later, or is there a process they have to go through to try to resolve that?
So once we got clued into the problem on the name formatting, we retrained our associates, and we got no help from DOJ on this, but we figured out a workaround where by entering the surname in the last name field, we were able to fake a match to the what the DMV has, and it is confirmed. You know, we're not selling the ammo to the wrong people. That comes up as a match, and so then they clear the transaction. Otherwise, they're just completely out of luck. I tell you what, over this holiday season, we had maybe not quite a dozen, but 10 non-residents who were here and wanted to go shooting, have some fun with the family. And they weren't able to buy ammunition because they didn't have a license. You have to have a California license or a California certificate of eligibility to buy ammo here. Of course, Arizona resident isn't going to apply for a California certificate of eligibility. So mm-hmm. They were out of luck. Now, the state will tell you, oh, well, you can just buy ammo at the range. Not these guys. We had two different parties shooting cowboy action. One of them needed 45 Long Colt. The other one needed 38 Smith & Wesson, which is not the same as 38 Special. And the range doesn't sell that stuff. They got your 45 ACP. They got your 9mm, 38 Special, but they didn't have those slightly more unusual calibers. We're the only guys who had it, and we couldn't sell it to them. So they didn't get to shoot.
That's terrible. That's sad.
Yeah, I promise you, they're not robbing 7-Elevens with a single action, 45 Long Colt. Oh, my goodness.
That's ridiculous. The best advice for anybody listening out there who's wondering whether or not they can buy ammo, wouldn't you say the best advice is go buy a gun, because then you're definitely in the system?
Well, I love that advice as a gun retailer, absolutely. If that's not quite in the budget, then you can use the CFARS, CFARS system. Just type that into your internet search box. It's the California Firearms Automated
Reporting System. What is it, CFARS?
CFARS, yeah.
CFARS, F as in Frank, CFARS.
Yep, and type that into your internet search box, and that will take you to the California Firearms Reporting System. You can tell them what you have. Just register one of your guns, one that's hopefully already registered, and pay them maybe $15 for the privilege, mm-hmm. and then they will know that that's where you live with a gun.
So, Dave, not you know, raining on Mike's parade to help you sell guns. If those people came in and they were out of state and they bought a gun, they'd have to wait 10 days, right?
Well, yeah, those folks aren't eligible, because you can't buy a gun in California as a non-resident. You have to, gotcha. Unless you're an active duty military.
Gotcha. So they'd have to move to California, get a California driver's license, show residency, and right. then buy a box of ammo.
That is just not going to happen. And I tell you, I see that as a infringement of
yes.
the United States Constitution. Those are U.S. residents being denied the right to feed their guns in one of the most populous states in the union.
We'll get John Dillon on that one next.
Yeah.
Because that's what it's going to take. It's going to take a lawsuit.
Absolutely will. I don't have a lot of time left in my segment. And guys, I just want to, have you gone over the changes that are coming next week?
Changes
in the gun laws?
Changes.
No, please do.
Yeah, go ahead.
We got a lot of stuff. I will summarize, and I'll start with the most important. Starting January 1st, background check fees for guns are going to skyrocket. Right now, you pay $25 for a background check, $35 for a PPT. It's going to go to $37.19 for the DROS. Or a PPT, a whopping $47.19. They snuck in emergency regulations at the last minute. They had an emergency hearing on Friday, and they snuck these under the wire. It's going to cost almost twice as much to buy a gun on your background check, and that is just pure added fees.
Mm-hmm. Emergency. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, they probably did it at 11 o'clock at night.
Yeah, yeah. Another serious one, we pay a lot of attention to CCWs. The state eliminated the $100 cap on CCW processing fees. Now there are unlimited fees for the counties, whatever they want to charge, to price people out of being able to defend their lives like they did over in White Settlement, Texas today.
Who is that up to? Is that the state?
That is up to the sheriff. The sheriff will set his or her own fees. So you need to get the right sheriffs in office who are issuing CCWs, and you need to make sure that they're not going to do back-channel de facto elimination of CCWs by charging people $1,000.
Now, I can already hear our audience grumbling about Sheriff Gore jacking up the fees, but he actually went on record and opposed this.
Fantastic.
So, yeah.
Oh, he did.
He did.
I'm so thankful that people can grow and come to a greater understanding as they live out their lives. And Sheriff Gore has really turned around on CCWs. And
he really has.
Appreciate his system. Yep.
Yeah.
A few other things. I'll hit them quickly.
Sure. Go ahead. No, you got time. We'll give you a little time.
Thank you. There's a second whammy. California AB 18. That's been referred to appropriations, and so they're going to hit it the next time they get into session. This will assess an excise tax on all firearm sales in California for another $25, and they will assess an as-yet-undetermined percentage fee on all ammunition sales. So that means you're going to be up past $50. That's almost $60 to do a background check for a gun in California. That was slated to take effect on January 1st, but they couldn't get it through one of the committees. They got kicked back. They did get it to appropriations, so we'll see it on the floor next session. Nice. Two more important ones. An unlocked gun that is removed from a home by either a minor or a prohibited person equals a 10-year ban on gun ownership of the person who owned that gun, no matter how they got it.
Yeah, and that new law extended that to unloaded unlocked guns, too. Before, it was the storage thing specifically talked about loaded guns.
Loaded, you're
and
right.
Now it's, yeah, even an unloaded gun. So,
my gosh.
Second most important, an unlicensed seller. So someone who's not an FFL. We got a lot of listeners who I know have a lot of guns, a lot more than that recently published average gun owner has. What do they say?
Eight.
Six or yeah, eight, is it now?
Yep.
Yeah. I don't know anybody with just eight guns. Come on now. Anyway, so, you know, folks buy and trade and sell all the time, and they do it legally with the background check system. But now, if you're not an FFL, you can only do six transfers per year. You can transfer any number of guns in one of those six transfers, but only up to a total of 50. More than that, you're guilty of dealing firearms as an unlicensed seller.
Jesus. You know, maybe one of these years they'll get it right and they'll start passing laws that work and make sense.
Well, we got to support the San Diego County gun owners.
You got it.
Make sure we get the right people in office. I got one more to throw at you.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
One more. It is the gun violence restraining orders. Have you ever not gotten along with an employee, a coworker, or a teacher? Any one of those people can now report you as a armed and dangerous person, and they just don't like how you're behaving, and you get a slap with a gun violence restraining order.
Doesn't surprise me in the least. David, it's always good talking to you. You're a plethora of knowledge. Folks, that's A.O. Sword. You need to go down here and check him out. I mean, I'm telling you, he will sit there and give you all the positive information and the correct information so you don't get in trouble down the road. David, thank you very much, and I hope you have a happy prosperous new year.
You too, guys. Take care.
All right, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, Sam the Gunman is in the wings. He's going through his dictionary of gun stories. He's going to try to beat us again right here on Gun Sports Radio, FM 96.1, AM 1170.
The Answer.
AM 1170,
The Answer.
The segment is brought to you by, or actually, California assault weapon laws make it almost impossible to own an AR pattern rifle. What's the solution? Cali Key. Converts any mil-spec direct impingement AR platform rifle into a straight-pull bolt-action rifle as it has. Have all the features without being considered an assault weapon. It's a true drop-in solution, no milling, no aesthetic modification. No turning off your gas system. Keep your entire AR collection intact with Cali Key. Cali Key, CaliKey.com. Self-defense and emergencies can happen to anyone, and unfortunately, the justice system may not be on your side. While you protect your family and protect your U.S. and property, U.S. LawShield is here to defend you 24/7, 365 days a year, with the comprehensive self-defense coverage at an affordable price. Bad guys don't take days off, and neither does our coverage. What's your plan after you defend yourself or your family? Consider a plan from U.S. LawShield. Check them out today at uslawshield.com. That's uslawshield.com. Hey, home mortgage interest rates have dropped as well. And if you're looking to buy, refi, or maybe even a reverse mortgage, we got just the guy for you, Chris Wiley. PRMI Mortgage. For nearly 25 years, Chris has been helping local San Diegans with all their mortgage needs. Give Chris a call at 619-722-1303 or go to primeres.com/alpine. Hey, who you got on next?
Well, I couldn't be more proud right now. My wife heard that on the last segment that the average gun owner has eight firearms, and she sent me a message and said, I only have seven. I need to get one more. And I said, no, I don't think, I said, name them. So she named them, and I said, oh, you're missing one. And she said, oh, yeah, I forgot. I do have eight. And she said, I still want another one, though. So both those things are very, very gun owner. To number one, forget a gun that you own. And number two, still want one. I couldn't be more proud right now.
She's such a lady.
She's great. All right. So every week we do everybody's favorite segment, Stump My Nephew, where we ask my nephew, Sam the Gunman, a trivia question about guns. He is completely and totally unprepared and unaware of what question it's going to be. And if we use your question, you get a T-shirt. If you stump him, if he can't answer your question, then you get a San Diego County Gun Owner's hat. So, Sam, the gunman, are you there?
Hi, how are you guys?
Fantastic.
Hey, did you have a good Christmas?
No, I didn't. I celebrate Hanukkah.
Oh, okay. Well, that sounds great.
Did you get everything you wanted for Hanukkah?
Yeah.
Did you get a gun? They get you a gun?
No.
No. All right. Well, there's always next year.
What's that?
Get you a hat?
Yeah.
See? I knew.
All right. You ready, Sam?
All right. Here it comes.
You're completely unprepared. You have no idea what's coming. This was emailed to us just a couple days ago. Jose in Chula Vista, he writes, last week you did a great job with a Christmas question, and I have another. Die Hard is my favorite Christmas movie. What gun did John McClane have in the famous Yippee-ki-yay scene?
By the way, is that the Chula Vista of East County or the actual Chula Vista?
I don't know. Well, it's in South County.
Yeah, it's in South Bay.
Is there, is there a real and a fake Chula Vista?
Yeah, didn't you say Santee was the, or was that the...
No. We're the La Jolla
of East County.
East County.
Oh, excuse me.
How dare you, young man.
Of East County. I'm so sorry. Now,
box this kid's ears next time I see him.
Now, wait a minute. Is this the gun you're talking about that was taped to his back?
It's taped to his back, right.
Okay. And then here's the caveat. I haven't actually seen Die Hard. I know all the guns they use in the movie, but I don't know which one he was using in that scene. Given that it was the one taped to his back, I would say it was John McClane's Beretta 92FS. And interestingly, the character is supposed to be a New York police officer in that movie, but New York City police officers weren't authorized to carry semi-automatic pistols until, I believe, the year after the movie came out. They were still using revolvers at the time.
This kid just...
That's absolutely correct.
This just kills me. He hasn't even seen the movie, but he knows what gun...
What movie? Do you know that?
The editors for that movie, I think, did a pretty good job. You've got a lot of other interesting firearms playing supporting roles. You have those German gangsters with HK-94s cut down to look like MP5s.
That's unreal that you knew that. Okay, so real quick, before you go on, he's absolutely right about that.
I know.
If you watch the movie, everybody thinks those are MP5s.
Yeah, they don't have the paddle magazine release.
They're not MP5s. They actually took, because an MP5 is like a $5,000 gun, they took a cheaper H&K, what is it, 93? 94, and they cut it down to look exactly like an MP5. But if you look closely, it's not an MP5. I can't believe you knew that. And you haven't even seen the movie. All right, keep going.
Magazine release. You've also got someone's using a Steyr AUG at some point in the movie, and the lead gangster, I don't know his name, he's got
Hans Gruber.
HK-P7.
Yeah, Hans Gruber.
Yeah, Gruber.
Well, the other thing, how can I phrase this? Let me see if I can ask you another question. That movie made another gun that was very, very new at the time, extremely famous, and made airports very, very nervous about it. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Oh, yeah. John McClane, I think near the beginning of the movie, he says, you know, something, something, something. It's a Glock 7. It's made of ceramic. It's invisible on metal detectors, and it costs more than you make in a month. Well, first of all, there's no Glock 7. Second of all, they're not made of ceramic. They're polymer framed. And third, they are absolutely easy to detect on metal detectors. They've got a bunch of metal parts embedded in the frame, not to mention the slide and barrel. Also, they do not cost more than you make in a month.
Well, some people.
Some people.
No, they
don't. Depends on where you live.
Yeah, but it was so that throughout the late 80s and most of the 90s, there was this misconception Everybody thought that a Glock could go through a metal detector, that it was an all plastic gun, even though the slide is, you know what, slides like a pound of metal. So yeah, it was both good and bad for Glock. Glock got a lot of coverage off of that because people wanted to know what the heck it was, but then it was also bad for them because, gun grabbers would use it against them, that sort of thing.
Yeah, this was sort of the beginning of the age of the Wonder 9, and Glock getting all that publicity, even though it was kind of bad publicity, really sort of slingshotted them into the forefront of the American mind, especially because so many law enforcement agencies like the FBI were starting to adopt them.
That's amazing, my friend. That is very, very cool. All right, so what are you doing for New Year's? You hanging out?
Yeah, just hanging out at home for all I know.
You should rent Die Hard is what you should do.
Absolutely,
you know what?
Yeah.
I might have to do that.
Rent Die Hard, best Christmas movie I think out there. Maybe just short of a Christmas Story.
What was the one I told you about?
Die Hard had better be a really good movie.
Oh, yeah.
Den of Thieves? Have you seen that one, Den of Thieves?
I haven't even heard of that one.
Boy, you want to talk about a shoot 'em up show? But I don't know anything about the guns that they use, but oh my goodness, you would know every one of them.
Dave, I think Dave was describing they busted out a big old mounted Gatling gun and
put it on the hood of a Suburban and shot through the windshield out the back window and took out 30 cars.
But, yeah, those will do that 6,000 rounds.
Not a Christmas movie. The other Christmas movie you may want to check out, of course, is Lethal Weapon 2, which also featured a Beretta 92.
Just the original Lethal Weapon, right? Was the Christmas movie?
I thought it was Lethal Weapon 2 was the Christmas one. I could be wrong. Watch them both.
Watch them both. They're fun to watch. We all watched them.
I'll check out Die Hard.
All right, good job, Sam. All right, say hi to everybody
year.
For me.
You guys have a good night.
All right, take care, buddy. Hey, we really want to thank Firearms Legal Protection, San Diego County Gun Owners, TDT Construction, CCW USA, U.S. Law Shield, Cali Key, PRMI Mortgage, Gatsky Dillon & Balance, LLP, John Groff, The Gun Range San Diego, A.O. Sword Firearms Store at aosword.com. And I want to thank Lance, Michael Schwartz, Joe Drammissi, and, of course, Brendan Thomas for all their hard work. Go to Gun Sports Radio for podcasts, up-to-date. Go to San Diego County GunOwners.org or SDCGO.org or San Diego County GunOwners.com. Make sure you join up. Throw a couple bucks their way. It'll help keep you and your family safe. All right. New Year's right around the corner. Hope you guys all have a great New Year's.
You too, man. Happy New Year, everybody.
All right, folks.
Happy New Year. That's what I was
going to say. Right here on FM 96.1, AM 1170,
The Answer.
This program is sponsored by Dave Stahl.